30-50. Around the ball and make space for the swing, and her idol Steffi Graf would be more than happy to have one of those as her own. That's a superb shot.
She's not on the board in this third set.
Mark desperately needs to halt the run of five consecutive games from the end, and the only way she's going to do that is to start nailing that backhand.
Opportunity lost by the Australian Rodionova, who's having some discourse with herself.
Just the pace, isn't it? Thank you. I wonder if she drives a car the same way she plays her tennis. If so, I won't be renting a car when I go to Dubai next year on my holiday. I don't fancy her jumping the lights on me.
You're suggesting road rage. She just doesn't know how to win this game.
She just isn't changing up her game enough. She's kind of playing this match on Mirza's terms. She needs to break up the play with a little slice, a drop shot, something to take Mirza out of her range and comfort zone. It's just become very hit, 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 hasn't it? And that suits the Indian down to the ground.
Fourth time she has advantage in this game. She is on the board. Mirza leads 2-1 in the third and final set.
Mirza leads by 2-1.
Well, that must surely be a morale booster for her. It took some eking out.
Desperately important for Rodionova to win that game. That the longest game of the match and the first deuce game in the match that she's won. Has to start winning some of these key games. In a way, it was more lost by Mirza errors than actually won by a good strategy from Rodionova. And I'm sure she's very aware that this match is not really in those highly polished hands that she's got there. Her nails done, as all the Aussies have on this team in their very patriotic yellow and green. I wonder if she had that done at the village, Games Village Spa. Apparently it's a very popular pedicure centre there, which has been well used by the athletes. Oh, I must get my nails done. They look
if you wouldn't mind.
They look shocking, don't they?
There's 3,000 athletes in the Commonwealth Games village all mingling together and enjoying dinner and one another's hospitality.
Yep, there's a nightclub there called Quantum, apparently, which is the place to be. Well, Baden's took their own music, apparently, the other evening. They had the place absolutely pumping.
I wouldn't know. Early to bed, pretty much preparation, all the notes. And the notes tell me that Mirza is serving here at 2-1 ahead.
Not always a logical explanation for why Mirza's game comes and goes. It's a little like my Wi-Fi internet connection in my hotel room. Because the margins between her being dreadful and extremely good are so fine. Just place
three break points for the Australian.
Risky tennis.
He is biting his fingernails. A real tension in the air, and she is keeping him on tenterhooks. Here is Mirza. Two games all in the final set. To say when Rodionova was too loved down at the start of this set, she looked in deep trouble, but she's fought back.
Thank you.
Well, it's full Bollywood out here, isn't it? One of those Bollywood movies where there's lots of drama, but the outcome always comes good in the end. That's what they're hoping for out here.
Well, she's challenging here, is Rodionova. She thought that ball was out. In the jam lines. Out by a millionth of an inch. Call from Australia. Oh. But she's wondering whether it's a challenge again.
30-50.
Probably too late now.
It's too late. Always asking Nicole Pratt whether she should challenge or not. Nicole, no, Nicole would probably say, just get on with it, Anastasia. Really supposed to ask her coach before she challenges.
Thank you.
That point of the challenge is a very difficult thing to nip in the bud though. I'm not quite sure how you can stop it. Anastasia is hot rod at the moment, three games in a row.
Rodionova leads by 3-2.
And the onus very much on Sania Mirza again here.
Well, pressure back on Rodionova. There's been some big momentum swings the last eight games, five in a row for Mirza, now three in a row for Rodionova. Rodionova never looked comfortable with the lead at a set in one love. She really was cruising. Her game fell apart just at the time that Mirza clicked in.
But all finals should be closely contested, and this one certainly is. Little between the one and two seed. Had a tough day against fellow compatriot Sally Pierce yesterday, and she's been taken all the way again here, the number one seed.
She's tough, isn't she? Rodionova.
You can just sense the anxiety in the crowd again now. This is going a little bit like the first set did, when Mirza was struggling to find her rhythm. Three break points.
Love 40.
Aggressive Rodionova there, but she is the one who forges the lead of 4-2 in the decisive set. This is not going to script.
No, does anything in India.
To give Mirza a lift.
She's a woman though, Rodionova, she's used to grinding out things on the tour with her tennis. Very little help in her career.
Chance for Sania. Bertie Liver. Well, this is such a big point here for Rodionova. Point in the context of the match. Oh, and it's gone Rodionova's way.
30-40. So there are two challenges remaining.
Mirza was on her way to the chair, right? Predict the outcome of this one. The smiles are back. Some homemade flags, some national emblems. I think we all need a drink.
I won't argue with that, but this match is, in this final set particularly, has been about who copes with the lead, and neither have coped with it. So right, it just shows you what a Commonwealth Games gold medal means. You know, the tennis event hasn't got the best players in the world here, hasn't had the finest draw. It's more of a challenger event than a tour event, but when you get down to this, the nitty-gritty, and the fans are totally invested in it, they're both struggling with it. Getting over the finish line, with taking this all the way to get to the top of the podium.
Yes, let's not forget they are competing for the first ever Commonwealth Games gold medal in tennis.
It's not about forehands and backhands for me anymore, this is about nerve.
Beautifully put by Sam Smith. There's the message. I wonder if Sammy's read it. She's serving to get back to 4-all. Take nothing for granted in this match.
Remember hitting a backhand winner in this match. It's all about the forehand.
And he'd like a slight miss it off the racket.
30
The ladies got into the net. Paid off for the Australian.
Well, nice change up, and make very makeable volley there. I forget she's 28 in the world on the computer rankings in doubles. Surprised we haven't seen it a little more in the forecourt in this match.
Tells you everything about that. Point was good for Rodionova. It's 30 all. Crucial phase of the game yet again.
Imagination and creativity out here now.
Making Mirza run a bit. Giving her a run for her money and she's got it back to deuce. Rodionova. Well, is that the critical moment of this match? And is the gold medal hope slipping away for the Indian? 5-3 and Rodionova will serve for the match. It is a matter of inches, Sam, this game, and that effort from Mirza there was literally 2 inches, if that, long side.
She plays the lines, but this match, coming up to an hour and three quarters almost now, has become a very physical match. Australian women trained to the minute, in great shape. I wonder if that's an advantage as well for her. Mirza a little light on these kind of matches this year. Her footwork not quite as precise as it was. Not always in the right position to go for those huge shots that she has.
One last hope.
Rodionova just wants this, for me, a little too much. I just wonder if she can just hold herself together here. Almost feel that she needs a few free points from Mirza to get over the finish line.
Anastasia Rodionova chuntering away to herself again. 30 all. And she comes bouncing out as though as if determined to prove a point. She clearly still has the self-belief. His mistake opens the door to match point for Rodionova of Australia.
Would you expect anything less from Mirza? I thought Rodionova did the right thing, serving to the backhand wing. Did not expect such a great return as that from Mirza.
She's wasted a big chance there.
Well, to be honest, she didn't do anything wrong on that match point. She got a first serve in. Goodness me, she's feisty, isn't she? It went to the backhand, the wing was less likely to hit a winner. But hitting the front in this match has been tricky for both of them. Setemwa Love, she wobbled. Mirza, 2-love up in this final set. Her game went to pieces. But Mirza once again made it happen. Didn't back off when she was match point down, didn't push the ball, stayed very true to game. She really believes in her game, this young woman does. She's only 23 years of age.
Well, the crowd has been put to it as well here, but Mirza comes out to serve to get the back match back to 5-all.
15. Oh.
That's probably the best serve she's produced in the entire match.
Got another challenge in the call and the lead service line. The ball was called good.
Well, the ball was called good. Rodionova still has all three challenges remaining, so you can't blame her for going to Hawkeye. The royal challenge here, when the point belongs to Mirza.
30-15. There's challenging the call on the left service line.
Well, both players have two challenges remaining. The umpire's just reminded them of that. Optimistic.
Second serve.
Second serve, barely 70 miles an hour.
Flash of brilliance from Tania Mirza. She brings the match all square again at 5-all in the decisive set.
Mirza in all this noise and distraction and just pure pandemonium.
Even your friends from All India Radio leapt to their feet in applause there. Not that they're not neutral, of course.
Mirza under pressure.
Thank you. Quiet, please.
just saw a man in the crowd. Don't know if he plays tennis or not. Try and do a shadow swing of Mirza's forehand and shake his head rather violently, as if he could have done it better.
Rodionova. And the Australian wins her game quite easily, really. Well, that doesn't matter, as long as Mirza holds hers. And if Mirza does hold and take it to 6-6, we will, of course, have the tiebreak. Well, there's certainly been plenty of drama here for the crowd in Delhi to enjoy in their first test of Commonwealth Games tennis. Must be going through the minds of the two contestants here in this historic final. Victory, the only acceptable target.
Start for the game, but where she's so good is that she doesn't seem to get a knickers and a twist when she misses. She's an aggressive player, so she accepts the mistakes.
Clenched fist tells you again the Australian thinks she's in control of the game.
Really clear thinking under pressure. There's Mike Chappie, who's doing the shadow swings. He's driving his wife crazy sitting there.
Challenge Rodionova. I think she's a bit optimistic. I know what the crowd wants. It's out by some distance. 15-30.
Rodionova has one challenge remaining.
Digs deep into those resources, and your pal's on his feet, I think.
Well, if he goes for tiebreak, he's going to be beside himself. Wife's getting an earful.
Mirza wins a point, they raise the roof.
14-30.
Oh, Mirza. Mirza doesn't think it was a net. Pressure on the umpire.
First time we've seen any emotion from Mirza. That's why she's hung in this match. She's really kept her emotions under control in the most difficult of environments.
Admission, wasn't it?
Bang on the 2 hours now.
She is one cool customer. What pressure. Under the lights as well.
Thank you.
Well, that's an incredible point. And Anastasia remembers to apologise. Not that there's anything to apologise for, really. She has to go through it all again. Third match point to the Australian. Strikes back.
The more match points that come and go, and Prady will know this a long time on the tour, the more difficult it is to close out.
Thank you. Quiet, please.
Is some bright spark from the Aussie camp to shout out Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi. Can you imagine what the Indians would do? They'd be so confused if that happened.
Well, they are not the most advisable thing to do.
Greg Jones in the men's singles final. It would be up to him, I think, to lead that chant. Mirza is going to take this from here, surely.
Don't tempt fate. Again, they're just doing this for the drama to become a little bit more intense, I think.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, try not to speak during points, thank you.
It's now the longest game of the match so far. Circuits just burst on All India Radio.
Well, it doesn't matter how she wins a point, they all roar, don't they?
They're just beside themselves.
Stop the traffic in Mumbai. I bet the whole of Hyderabad's watching this as well. The hopes of the nation resting on Mirza. She squared it all up. We have a tie break here in Delhi. Maybe it's written in the stars. It's past his bedtime.
Thank you.
7:10 in the evening, if you're wondering. Point of the tie break to Australia.
Rodionova. Both players receive one additional challenge.
Thank you. two-point advantage for Australia. Is allowed one additional challenge in the tiebreak. Well, the ball was good and she knows it.
Mirza has one challenge remaining.
That's just as tense as the entire match has been all the way from first to last.
Well, it sets up for Rodionova. Just almost half an hour ago that she had her first gold medal point to stand on the top of the podium. That's a long time to think about what might have been.
Balls down, please.
Silence almost descends on centre court here in Delhi. As Rodionova will move to yet another match point. Is this her moment? To end, but it's a historic moment. The first ever Commonwealth Games gold medal in tennis goes to Anastasia Rodionova of Australia. But massive disappointment for India's darling Sania Mirza. was a battle royal that's gone Australia's way. And Anastasia Rodionova will win the gold medal here.
Well, it was a great effort, wasn't it, from Rodionova, who's only just got her Australian passport. I'm sure when she was growing up in Tambov in Russia, she'd never heard of the Commonwealth Games, but she's become a very proud Aussie.
Sani Mirza takes her leave of the centre court crowd. She did her best. She fought mightily, and you have to admire her courage, but it's just not quite good enough on the day.
Yeah, I just didn't think in the end it was one too many. It was just one unforced error too many. Rodionova plays a slightly more conservative game. And in the end, maybe the physical fitness of the Aussie made all the difference.
Never a great way to lose, but it was on the tiebreak. And Rodionova wins the gold medal, 6-3, 2-6, 7-6. She will return later to centre court to receive her reward.